Ευλογημένη Βασιλεία του Πατρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
St. Lawrence was a deacon in the Roman Church. St. Lawrence was born in Spain during the 3rd century at Osca, a town in Aragon near the foot of the Pyrenees. As a youth, he was sent to Saragossa to complete his studies. It was there that he first encountered the future bishop Sixtus. At this time, Christianity was still an illegal religion and would remain so for more than 5 decades to come. When Sixtus was made pope in 257, he ordained Lawrence deacon, and though Lawrence was still young, appointed him the first among the 7 deacons who served in the patriarchal church. Deacons, then as now, were liturgical assistants to bishops and priests, but were also in charge of distributing goods to the poor and widows of the church. St. Lawrence served under Sixtus II, Pope of Rome. In August of AD 258, Emperor Valerian issued an edict that all Christian bishops, priests, and deacons should be rounded up and put to death. The Valerian persecution was one of the last persecutions of Christians by a Roman emperor. It was relatively small-scale, targeting only Christian clergy and not the laity. It was also not long-lived, being ended by the next emperor. On August 6th, Pope Sixtus II was captured by the Romans and executed. St. Lawrence visited Sixtus in jail and watched his trial. While he visited Sixtus, St. Lawrence said that he wished he too would be martyred. Sixtus told him not to worry and that he would indeed be martyred in only 3 days' time. In short order, St. Lawrence himself was captured by the Romans and brought before the prefect, who had heard that St. Lawrence was in charge of distributing alms to the poor of the church. For this reason, the prefect thought that St. Lawrence would have access to significant wealth. The prefect of Rome demanded that St. Lawrence hand over the treasures of the church. St. Lawrence asked the prefect for 3 days in order to gather up the treasure. The prefect agreed to this request. During these 3 days, St. Lawrence distributed as much of the wealth of the church as possible to the poor, in an effort to keep it out of the hands of the Romans. He even went so far as to sell the sacred items of the church, such as the chalice, paten, and candlesticks, in order to give more money to the poor. When St. Lawrence went back to the prefect, he was ordered to hand over the wealth. St. Lawrence said that the wealth of the church was in the poor and needy. This enraged the prefect, and he ordered St. Lawrence executed. Legend maintains that he was killed by being roasted on a gridiron. Halfway through this horrific death, he is supposed to have said, "I'm well done, turn me over." At this time, the catacombs often contained churches, and Christians would celebrate their liturgies over the relics of martyrs. Even today, Roman Catholic altars contain a relic of a saint, and in order for a priest in the Eastern Orthodox Church to celebrate the Eucharist, he must do so on a cloth into which has been sewn the relic of a saint. St. Lawrence was buried in the Roman catacombs. It is uncertain if this story is true. It may have come from a copyist's error in a Latin manuscript describing the life and martyrdom of St. Lawrence. Whatever the case may be, it remains a prominent part of the story of the martyrdom of St. Lawrence. Since this time, the catacombs have been cleared away and the Church of San Lorenzo erected over the grave of St. Lawrence. The church contains the tomb, the slab his body was originally placed on, and the iron grate said to have been the one on which he was roasted alive. His tomb has not been moved since he was originally buried there. It remains the only original part of the catacombs left inside the church. The tomb is protected by metal bars, as is the gridiron, although both are in plain view. Pope Sixtus III built the Church of San Lorenzo in the 5th century. It is located in the east of modern Rome, but its location is outside the ancient city walls. In Western iconography, St. Lawrence is typically depicted wearing a dalmatic, a liturgical vestment worn by deacons in Western rites, and holding the gridiron on which he died. In Eastern iconography, he is usually depicted wearing an orarion and a sticharion. These are liturgical vestments worn by deacons in Eastern rites, and carrying a small church building in one hand. His other hand variously has a censer, a cross, or sometimes nothing. These are the words of a hymn to St. Lawrence. A flame in thy heart, O Lawrence, with fire divine, thou burnest away the fire of passions utterly. O firm staff of athletes, O thou God-bearing martyr, and thou in truth while contesting didst cry with faith, nothing shall separate me from the love of Christ. The feast of St. Lawrence is celebrated on August 10th, the day he was martyred. St. Lawrence is known as the patron saint of chefs and cooks because of his words, "I am well done, turn me over," during his execution. He is commemorated in the Roman Catholic Church, the Eastern Orthodox Church, the Anglican Communion, and by Lutherans.